Very distinguished friends, ladies and gentlemen, thank you, Father Warren, for letting us be here. Thank you, Advocates for International Development, for the privilege of having me speak to you. I hope you haven't heard any fluttering, because I have quite a bit of butterflies in the tum-tum. So let me tell you what the bee in my bonnet is. It is to say, with all of our remarkable diversity, that we are created for family. In our part of the world, we have something that is very difficult to put into English or any of the other languages. It is called ubuntu, the essence of being human. Adam could not be fully Adam without Eve. And so the story is about the fact that you and I are created for this delicate network of interdependence. The solitary human being is a contradiction in terms. I need other human beings in order for me to be human. When we had the privilege of being part of the Truth and Reconciliation Commission at home, frequently you were shattered as people confessed to some of the things that they did. We gave him drugged coffee, we shot him in the head, and we burned his body. And it takes 9-10 hours for a human body to burn. And as the human body is burning on this pyre here, we had a barbecue and we were drinking beer. And you see, what could have happened to the humanity of anyone? That they saw nothing horrendous in having two kinds of flesh burning. The depth of that depravity, that the death of a fellow human being would leave him cold. But then you see, it is precisely because you and I, whether we like it or not, are bound up in this incredible, the Bible calls it, bundle of life. And so, rich and poor, male, female, white, black, yellow, all, yes, gay, lesbian, so-called straight, all, still doesn't shock you. How about Israeli, Palestinian, Hamas, Fatah, Taliban. No, all, George Bush, Bin Laden, incredible, all, because you see, there are no outsiders. All are insiders, all held in this incredible embrace that will not let you go, that will not let anyone go. But all, hey, all. That is the ethic of family. And in many ways, it is the basis of the MDGs. My dear, dear sisters and brothers, dear friends, all of you, especially you fantastic young people, how in the name of everything that is good are we able still today to spend what can only be described as obscene amounts on budgets of death and destruction, when we know that a minute fraction of our so-called budgets for defense would ensure that children everywhere had clean water to drink. How in the name of everything that is good can we still tolerate that? And imagine that we are ensuring our security. There is no way we are ever going to win so-called wars against terror as long as there are conditions in the world that make people desperate. We are playing marbles. I don't know what the amounts signify. But I'm told that we have been spending just on nuclear armaments $1.6 trillion. I don't know. Between 20 and 30 million children are infected with measles. $1 would pay for the inoculation of one child against measles. Nearly 400,000 children die annually. It's a topsy-turvy world. It's a crazy world. Right?